anybody else want to come show their support, want to help out, I'm all for it. There's too many abandoned buildings in America, especially in Chicago. All these people that's been missing, they've been finding people in these buildings, these garbage cans. We didn't bring our people in the world like that. I'm damn sure ain't gonna let them go out the world like that. So if anybody got any information, please step forward. I'm available anytime. Anybody think they want to look over here or they want to check over here or call this number, see this or see that, I am willing to do it. I'm always willing to do it. I never sleep. I'm up 24 hours, 7 days a week. If I get a rest, it's by accident. But I'm right back up on it when I do wake up. So again, please come out, show your support, join my line. Help us search and find the missing and exploited men and women of America. It's a shame that we have to go through these steps to find our people.
Mr. Coles, can you talk to us a little bit about your latest conversations with detectives and what they're telling me, what, you know, what the difficulties are in terms of trying to find out what happened to your daughter?
Well, as of right now, as far as the update of finding this kid, who's the most, I have talked to CPD, and I've talked to a victim. There's been a lot of misunderstanding as far as good understanding too. But at the same time, they are up against a brick wall right now. They haven't stopped me, but I am out here. There's a lot of information they won't give you, or people won't give you, because they are the police. There's a lot of people not respecting the police at this point in time right now, because of all the unnecessary shootings, unarmed men being shot, unarmed women being shot, just a lot of records in America, period. Right now, they have no more need. So again, I would say, if you have any information, please reach out to me if you don't want to deal with me. I would reach out to you, as I do every day. Right now, we're to the point, they have a brick wall, they don't have any more information, and the information they do have are containing the right people they are that's involved. So right now, the people I know are over in Chicago, so it's been kind of hard for them to really like apprehend. At the same time, they're waiting on them to show up or whatever they need to do. Again, I'm going to continue to be out here 24 hours, 7 days. I'm not hard to find. Reach out to them so we can bring our loved ones home, being the missing and destroyed men and women of America. This Kiera Coles, along with the little boss, know I'm out here 24 hours, 7 days a week. I would like for everyone to have a loved one or a missing relative, friend, whatever it might be, to reach out. If you don't have the resources, reach out to me and I can probably help guide you in the right direction in order to help bring our loved ones home safely.
Sir, you were telling me also that you believe your daughter is alive and you're holding on to that.
Absolutely.
Yes, I do believe. Let's clear that up right away. I do believe my daughter is still alive. There's been several women held in these houses, handcuffed to ready, that's still alive, that we all thought was either dead or still gone somewhere. That's where they were found. Now, the women are being smart enough to work together to escape these chambers or houses they might be in. There's still a lot of vacant houses out here in Chicago. Reach out to me. If y'all are really concerned, reach out to me. Let's go knock on these doors. Let's go kick in some of these garages.
Yes.
Let's check these abandoned houses, because there are several abandoned houses in there, especially in Chicago. In the area where my daughter came on missing from, there's at least over 50 houses that are vacant. I done kicked in half of them. I done dug up in the ground. I done looked in the sewers. And I will continue to do this until I bring her home safely.
Yes.